Hello Gundam fans, this is Prime92, and today I'll be looking at the 1144 High Grade Mega Shiki from the Gundam Build Fighter Tri-Series. And this is a rather heavily modified Delta Gundam, not the Delta Kai or the Delta Plus. It's the gold chrome version that I've already reviewed. And quite a few new pieces. You got the new head, which it definitely has a Hayaku Shiki look. It's like a sleeker Hayaku Shiki head. And then you got the torso, which is entirely new. The shoulder armor and the actual shoulders, the arm guards, front and side skirts, and the middle piece here, and the feet, which I love these feet. They're so different. Like, just a little bit, just having them come down and just a little bit of the actual white. And the torso, a really small stomach, and you think that'd be weird, but I really like it. It gives it a Super Robot Wars kind of look. So even if it's standing still, it kind of looks like it's doing the whole crotch thrust thing. Where it's like ready to go. And these are the connectors for the Mega Ride Launcher, but in the show, they were thrusters, even though they don't look like it. That's what they did, so. Yeah, I really like the arm guards. They're neat. Just because it's the same arm. But a little bit of extra bulk. Which definitely helps, because without those, because of how tall he is now, it would definitely look weird if these arms weren't so bulky. But I really like it. You only have three stickers. Forehead camera, back of the head, and the black eyes. You don't get the ones that show the actual, like, the eyes. It was the one time at the end of the, was it 8? Episode 8? Or it was like, badly damaged, and was trying to power back up, and he saw the eyes flash, and that was it. But that was the only time. They're usually black, so I'm fine with this. And it holds together really well. It stands well. I love the design of this thing. It looks amazing. Now the head goes up and down some, and it can go up at the neck and the collar only a little, just because of how much, like there is on the head, the little overhang there. Rotate some. Arms go forward and back a little. Out. Rotate. They rotate below the shoulder. One joint at the elbow. You got a ball joint at wrist. And the new arm guards actually have a double hinge to fold these back. So you can actually have full access of the hands. Which is a good idea. And the way the waist is sculpted, you got super amount of articulation there, and no hindrance. Front skirts are pretty good. You can separate them if you want. Side skirts are interesting because they have a hinge, just like the original. It's hinged in the back skirt here, but then there's this little flap that goes forward. I don't know why, because you can't really access it because of the front skirts. They kind of cover that, so the only way you can do it is do this. I don't really know why. I guess just to add a little bit to the front for design purposes. And you get the, even that, with that you can get the legs pretty far forward. Not much back. Out some. And they bend at the knee at 2 points. And then you have the ball jointed foot. Very good. And the ankle armor. And that's it. No toe articulation, but because of how good the ankle is, you can still get a pretty wide stance with this thing. This really is made for good dynamic poses with those ankles and the torso. Yeah, really good articulation. Now, the normal weaponry of the Mega Shiki, you have the beam rifle, which is the same as the Delta Gundam. Even has the flip-out handle, which I don't think there's anywhere to peg it on. Like, when you flip the handle back. At least not really. And it easily fits into the hand. Don't even have to take the hand apart. Just goes right in. Really nice. And you also have a couple sets of hands. You got a set of holding hands. A set of open hands. And fist hands. And these are from the little extra plate they give you with, usually with GMs. But But it's a good idea. If they're just simple hands, they're basic, nothing special about them. It's an easy thing to throw that plate in. You got more hands. Now, the other accessory I have to show the actual backpack. This is the Mega Ride Launcher. Alright. This is the accessory that it has, and this is like its main weapon. Well, not pretty much main attack. Its most powerful attack. Let's say that. So, to mount it to the Mega Shiki, just make sure that this tab here is flipped down, and these two, which are on hinges here and at the top, make sure they're all together facing forward, and they'll peg into those three holes in the backpack. Right like that. Now, I tried to do it with the one middle one by itself, but it's too loose. So it needs those other two. And now, the Mega Shi is fully equipped with the backpack. Now, it is a little more back-heavy, but it doesn't take too much to get him to stand properly. Because there's a lot of, like, surface on these feet. So it just has to kind of lean just a little bit so it can stand up. Pretty good. So this is obviously the compact mode, like the when it's attached. And then if you want to have it in the flight mode, well, they tell you to actually do this and then pull off these, their own ball joints. Just rotate them up. It's not a big deal. As you have like that. Same thing on the other side. Just paint them in right there. And then you can flip out the wings. And they actually have the other... It's the same wings as the Delta Gundam, so you have the little extra ones. You might as well flip them out, right? So they're there. Got that. Alright. And then... now, you're supposed to... These... I don't know why they did this, because they could have, I think, easily fixed this. These are just pegged in right here. And then what you're supposed to do is peg them in here. Like that. And they're supposed to kind of like act like landing gear, I guess. Like skis. But if they had made this like a rectangle shape, and that a rectangle shape instead of a circle, it would have been able to peg fine into the backpack by itself without these. Because these are kind of like hydraulics. As you can see. And you can easily have them stored like that when it's in backpack mode, but because it needs all three pegs, you can't do that. You have to have those pegs up here to keep it solid. If this was rectangular, that probably wouldn't happen. I know it's weird, but I think it would have been nice to actually be able to keep these like this, instead of having a parts for it. And then you're supposed to flip out this handle, like that. And then you can take the Mega Shiki. This is where getting that hand cover back comes in handy. And just separate the hand. Be careful of these hands, because I have had some of the other Delta Gundam variants with their hands break, this peg here break off. So I would suggest you be careful. But if you can get his hand fed through there, easier seen done, I suppose. Are you supposed to take the hand cover off? I guess you are. Because I don't think it'll fit with the hand cover on. Yeah, it's a little too thick. Huh. I haven't actually tried this before. But now I know. And knowing is half the battle. Alright, so plop that back on. There! There we go. And this is how you saw it at the beginning of the fight with Team Bill the... was it Tri-Fighters? Like that. The Mega Ride Launcher flying him into battle. Which is like a lot like what the Mega Launcher did on the original series in Zeta, with the Hayako Shiki. It could be used to fly the Hayako Shiki into battle. However, this is going to be a long video, probably, because I have... There is a variant. They don't show you. But you can do it, because why the hell not? It's pretty much there. So you might as well do it. So I'm going to start by... Well, let's keep this off. I'm gonna start by putting these, unfortunately. I had to put them back. I'm paying these back up here. Flip that handle back down. And then put those back. Like that. Alright. And then peg this back into the the Mega Shiki. Alright. Get those wings back on. I think you know where I'm going with this. It's basically a Wave Rider mode. Because it's all there. It's all essentially the same as a actual Gundam would do. Actually, I guess we can keep that like that. Because you can bring the... This thing's on a double hinge. Actually, a triple hinge, really. So you can bring that down. Rotate these. The covers will cover the hand. Like that. Then you can have the feet. Yeah, you can kind of... I mean, I guess you could rotate the waist, but you have to deal with this stuff here, so just... Whoops. Yeah, just leave it like that. Pretty much. I mean, it's basically a Wave Rider mode. It's not any worse than any other modes, and you have the nose cone with the cannon. I don't see why not. I'm surprised it didn't do that. But anyways. There's also kind of, you know how, have anybody seen the Vrabe? I think it's called that, the Hainu Vrabe. It has a backpack that turns into a birdie. Well, you know what? So does this. And it's very simple. I got feet and legs. Kind of like tail fins here. You got the wings on ball joints. And you've got the head. So yes. You have a bird mode with the backpack. Why not? If the Hainu Vrabe can do it, why not this too? I don't think it looks any less credible. And it's got feathers, so why the hell not? And they look like feet and talons, and they move, and the head moves. So yeah, I think it works. Now, enough of the fan modes, let's actually get back to the official modes. Because there is the actual firing mode, which you did in the show. So, get the Mega Shiki prepped. All you have to do, take the crotch piece, and peg it down here. And that's pretty much all you have to do. Just, you can get his arms out if you want. Just get the hands rotated. Alright. Now here, we just flip that peg, flip it down, it seems to fit better down, like that. Alright, now we can put these forward, for now. These thrusters come down, you can flip the little handles out on the side, like that. Now this peg comes out and back, alright. Now, this peg is going to peg into that hole right there. Okay, right like that. It's a little hard to do because the peg likes to move. But if you get it right like there, if you can see it, how it's pegged into the front hole. Not the back one, the front one. Alright, then... You got those handles that just came out, so the Mega Shiki can... Yeah, let's get these wings off, or it'll be a little bit of a pain. But you can get the hands to hold on the side. Like that. Might need to bend them a bit. Just keep everything up and close and personal. These are supposed to press up against the front skirts, like that. Right? Now you can extend this part, like that. Which is... you can do it whenever you want. I think it looks a little better to keep this back and this extended. And then you can just peg these back on. Like that. And that... is essentially the Mega Ride Launcher Cannon mode is actually pretty cool. I like how it looks. I like how they try to make it look like it's being supported against the Mega Shiki with these parts, but it's actually this peg in the middle, which it's hard to see with all the stuff going on. You got the thrusters down here, which have the handles. You got the can in the front, which looks really cool looking. The wings actually add to it. Even with the wings, it doesn't really look too bad. Whoops. But it does kind of lose a little bit of something with those wings, I feel. But I think it's pretty cool. I like this mode. And you know what else? I think this could actually be used for, like, a riding vehicle. If you got, like, wheels or something. Because, does that not look like a driver's seat? Does that not look like a seat? Like, it could be like a hover bike. Right? Am I crazy? Does that look like, it looks like a seat. Where? I don't know. That's what it looks like. Yeah, this thing is pretty cool, and it's a lot more versatile than you might initially think, if you read the instructions. Seems to have a few little hidden things. Well, I mean, mostly my imagination, I guess, but it does have... It looked legit. And there's some holes here for... I don't know what they're for. Who knows? Whatever you want. But yeah, I actually like that bird mode, and I also like the, with a little more, fiddling. The Wave Rider mode can look even better. More, credible. So, yeah, those are the accessories, but of course there's also the beam saber handles, which are attached to these wings right here. You just unpeg them. Be careful, because I can see these snapping if you pull that way. Make sure you pull out, away. And I love, love, love these beams. They're katana shape. It's all like the, Marasai. I think it's the Marasai. No, not Marasai. The Murasame? Oh, wait. The one that Graham Aker had. I mean, they're pretty cool. Yep, and of course you can peg these onto the, onto the side. Just gotta rotate these back. Just make sure the beam saber handles are facing out. I mean, you can still have them outwards, but this is save a little bit of space. Now that's pretty cool. I really like this thing. Weapons are great. Of course, you do have other parts, because it does have a lot of the Delta Gundam pieces, most notably the head. So if you really like the head of the Delta Gundam, you can just swap it around. And there you go. But personally, I don't feel it fits the actual design of this body. And there are other pieces. There's parts of the shield, parts of the skirt armor, the shoulders, but there's not enough to actually make a complete Delta Gundam. So if you want a Delta Gundam in this color, you're gonna have to repaint the other one, which means you're gonna have to get rid of that gold chrome. And I'm not about to do that with mine. So those are the accessories. I love them so much. This Mega Ride Launcher is awesome. So, comparisons. Well, we're going to get the actual Hayaku Shiki family, minus one, the one I actually customized. But, here is the Hayaku Shiki. Now, this is the one that came with the actual Mega Launcher, so it's that mustard color. But you can see, yeah, Mega Shiki's quite a bit taller than its daddy, granddaddy. And then, yeah, the backpack is a little heavy, but you can work around it. And then how about the Delta Plus, which is actually still... Delta Plus is tall. Delta Plus is about the size of a unicorn, and he's still taller. That's saying something. And of course, the one it's based on, the bling known as Delta Gundam. Oops. And yeah, it is still taller than the Delta Gundam because of those feet and because of the torso. It raises it up. It is tall. So I absolutely adore the Mega Shiki. I love this mobile suit. It has a wonderful design, taking the actual mold of the Delta Gundam and making it its own. It's got really good articulation, especially because of the new pieces in the torso and the ankles. I love the accessories. This Mega Ride Launcher is badass. And you can do a lot of fan modes with it if you want. Beam Rifle's fine, it's the old one. And I really like these beams. And it's really tall in it. I love this thing. I love the design. It is a great mobile suit. Unlike the Wedding Gundam, where in my opinion it was worse in person than it was in the show, I find this is the opposite. I like it more now than I did in the show. So that's about it, and I'll see you at the next review.